Hello, my name is Mallory, and I'm a pediatric infectious diseases pharmacist here at Orlando Health Arnold Palmer Hospital for Children. I'm going to talk to you today about an oral antibiotic that your child will be taking at home. The antibiotic is in a medication class called fluoroquinolone antibiotics, which includes ciprofloxacin and levofloxacin. This medication is needed to treat your child's bacterial infection. Fluoroquinolone antibiotics work by killing the germs in your child's body at high concentrations, as long as the antibiotic is being taken appropriately. It is very important that your child takes every single dose of the antibiotic at the appropriate time to make sure that there's enough antibiotic in your child's body to kill the bacteria and treat the infection. The amount of times to take the antibiotic per day depends on the specific medication, and your child will likely be taking it once or twice per day. Review the label on the prescription bottle to ensure that you understand the dosing instructions. Have your child take the medication at the same times every day, ideally in evenly spaced intervals. If the formulation of the antibiotic that your child will be taking at home is liquid, make sure to give each dose with an accurate measuring device, such as an oral syringe. Do not use a household teaspoon or tablespoon, as these are not accurate measuring devices for medication administration. It is necessary to shake some liquid antibiotics before measuring out the dose, so please check the label for instructions that will tell you to shake well if this is needed. While abdominal pain and diarrhea are the most common side effects of these medications, other side effects that your child might have include nausea or vomiting, headache, restlessness, diaper rash, or allergic reaction causing hives, swelling, or trouble breathing. Rare side effects of this medication can include tendonitis or tendon rupture, which would present as severe pain in the tendon or joint, which gets worse with movement. Another rare side effect is called peripheral neuropathy, which would present as pain, pins and needles sensation, numbness, and weakness in the arms, fingers, legs, or toes. If you think your child is experiencing one of these rare side effects or a severe allergic reaction, such as anaphylaxis, it is important to seek medical attention right away. If your child does experience stomach upset when taking this medication, taking it with food can help, so make sure to ask your nurse or pharmacist if this specific antibiotic can be taken with food. Do not take this medication alone with dairy products like milk or yogurt or calcium-fortified juice. However, the antibiotic can be taken with meals that contain these items. Do not take this medication at the same time as magnesium or aluminum containing antacids, as this can decrease the absorption of the antibiotic. So the medicine should be taken 2 hours before or 6 hours after antacids or products containing calcium, iron, or zinc. Always have your child use sunscreen, avoid tanning beds, and avoid excessive exposure to sunlight while on this medication to avoid severe sunburn. If your child misses a dose of the medication, give the missed dose as soon as you remember. However, if it is almost time for the next dose, skip the missed dose and return to your regular schedule. Do not double doses or take extra doses. When you get home, keep the medication in a dry place away from heat or moisture. Review the package insert or talk to your nurse or pharmacist about whether or not this medication needs to be refrigerated. Fluoroquinolone antibiotics are extremely helpful to treat all different types of infections. Make sure to listen closely to instructions described by your doctor so you know if or when to return to the emergency room or be seen by the primary care physician. Please let your nurse, doctor, or pharmacist know if you have any questions at all about this medication. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.